Another molecule in the benzimidazole family is known as oxibendazole, which has a molecular structure that looks like this and is often abbreviated as OBZ. It's used in veterinary medicine for the treatment of threadworm, pinworm, gastrointestinal nematodes, as well as lungworm. And the way that it works is if we zoom in on some of these parasites, they're composed of microtubules that are necessary for structural integrity, as well as transporting some critical nutrients. But if we zoom in even closer, those microtubules are composed of two other components known as alpha and beta tubulin, which need to come together or polymerize in order to form those microtubules. However, when oxibendazole is added, it's going to specifically target a part of beta tubulin and attach to it. This prevents it from interacting with alpha tubulin, so therefore we don't see as many microtubules being formed, and therefore the parasite has a compromised structural integrity, as well as nutrient transport is inhibited. So things like glucose are not moved around the cell like needed. Therefore, we see increased amounts of cell death and eventually death of the parasite. And you may notice that some of these different drugs work very similar, such as fenbendazole, mabendazole, or albendazole. And that's because you may have heard of things like bacterial resistance to antibiotics. And the same thing can happen for parasites. So we need to have a variety of different pharmaceuticals available in case those parasites do become resistant to certain chemicals. So make sure to stay connected to my channel and with Dane Garvin, and leave a comment below on the next molecule you want to see broken down.